Mario 3 is dying, and we need to save it. Well, I don't know if it is actually dying, but I wanted to make a video and kind of go through all the little things about Mario 3 and about the speedrunning and how I've had defect and how other things have played a role trying to figure out whether or not Mario 3 speedrunning is dying. I've been thinking about this for a while, and ever since I kind of stopped speedrunning Mario 3 after I got some of the runs that I kind of wanted to get, I've been keeping a close eye on Mario 3 speedrunning, and I have been asking myself, is Mario 3 speedrunning dying? Is it, what's happening with it? Is there someone new coming out of the shadows eventually and they're going to start taking the runs? Is somebody practicing offline? Or has everyone just kind of paused and taken a Mario 3 break after, well, not after, but I mean all at the same time? Did everyone just kind of stop? I just wanted to make this video, and we're going to run through a couple little things. I'm going to actually go on Twitch and we're going to see like what kind of viewers Mario 3 is having. A really bad article that was written a few days ago as well about like a new glitch discovered, and it's just like it's not even close to new. It's extremely old, and I'm pretty sure it used some kind of either debugging or it used, I think, a Game Genie code to allow you to go on the map. And it just, like, Mario 3 isn't even getting relevant news anymore. So is it actually dying? Let's find out. Let's take a look. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take a look at Twitch. We're gonna go right to Twitch right away. Bam, Twitch has got a lot of ads. You don't have I have Turbo, so I mean I never see these ads or anything. But let's go to Super Mario Bros. 3. And first and foremost, let's just take a look. First thing to come up is related channels to my search. That's not even Mario 3. Good job, Twitch. Yo, third wall, what up? Let's see, Super Mario Bros. 3 right here, 41 viewers, not bad, but it's weird though, we click on it, it's got almost 500,000 followers, and it's got 41 viewers, so, what's the question here? Is it popular, is it not popular, is this a normal weekday for Mario Bros. 3? And honestly, in my opinion, I would say that Mario 3, to begin with, has not been a crazy popular game, but at the same time it has been very popular. It's all about what you do with Mario 3, because it's such a fan favorite and everyone loves this game. If you stop in on a run that's like after World 4 Airship, you're gonna generate a lot of traffic, right? If you're doing a run and you're in World 1 and 2, people are gonna leave and they're gonna go do something else. They're gonna wait to see if you get good RNG, and then they'll come back and they'll take a look and see what's going on. So nobody here though is speedrunning Mario 3. They're all casual plays. So, I mean, anyone looking would assume, yeah, I mean, this game is probably dead in terms of Twitch. But let's go take a look at YouTube, actually. And let's just type in Super Mario Bros. 3 on YouTube. Super Mario Bros. 3 complete walkthrough. 1 year ago, not bad. The History of Mario 3, that was a year ago. I remember watching that. If you guys haven't seen that, that's a really good video. Then we get a lot of the Super Mario Show, which doesn't really have anything to do with the game. I mean, it does, obviously, but in terms of speedrunning and popularity with speedruns, this doesn't really have anything to do with speedrunning. Secrets, old. Long play, this is old. Back to the Show. A very bad IGN video that kind of like ripped off Kurua. Should have at least given him something for it. Jeez, they just take the video and post it, and then they get... Yeah, I've never been a huge fan of IGN. Some All-Star stuff. Full game walkthrough. 401k. Angry video game nerd, of course. So, speedrunning doesn't even pop up when you type in Super Mario Bros. 3. But if you type in Super Mario Bros. 3 speedrun, we get the IGN thing. Which, again, it's the worst. We got the Darbyan, of course. We get, I don't know what this is, but a 432 5 years ago. We get the Summoning Salt video, which was 3 years ago. So Summoning Salt hasn't really touched up on Mario 3 stuff in quite a while. We get some more Kurua stuff. Yeah, and then there's, you know, there's obviously going to be a couple of my videos littered in there. We got the TAS. But as you can, oh, we got the business video. But as you can see, a year ago, I had recently got the world record. It's about 4 months ago. So that was kind of the last thing that I touched up on with Mario 3. So it just goes to show that even on YouTube, Mario 3 isn't really getting much traction. So let's go ahead and take a look at that thing that I mentioned earlier, that article. Super Mario Bros. 3 News. I always mess up typing all the time. I'm like faster than what my hand. Okay, so Super Mario Bros. 3 player makes new out of bounds. By Game Rant. I don't know if anyone follows Game Rant or does much with Game Rant, but apparently some Super Mario Bros. 3 player makes new out-of-bounds discovery decades after release. A new out-of-bounds glitch is discovered through Super Mario Bros. 3 that allows player to swap from Mario to Luigi in an odd way. Breaking video games on Twitch. Yes, yes, yes. It's very exciting. Provide home for speedrunners to YouTube. I saw this thing and it doesn't really do anything for speedrunning. Now breaking video games. The latest target is once more Super Mario Bros. 3 with a previously undiscovered boundary break leading back to surprising out of bounds area of the game. Okay. We'll take a quick little look here. Okay, so what he's doing right now is not something you can do by powering on the game. That's not, like, you can't do that when turning on the game. It doesn't work. If it worked, you would go to tile, you would go down to like tile 5 and you'd beat the 5th level. You'd skip all those levels, right? That would be used in Warpless. This isn't a real glitch. I mean, it's real obviously, but you have to put in a Game Genie code. You have to mess with something. So he goes to this menu, and just for anyone who doesn't know, every tile on the overworld map actually has something that where if you click, it'll most likely pull you in. Most of the time, it pulls you into a Hammer Brother battle without any Hammer Brothers in it. But in this case, it doesn't actually do that. It takes you to the warp zone, or it takes you to the battle zone. And I'm not sure why it does Luigi and stuff like that. Maybe this specific thing has not been discovered, but nobody is gonna walk around on every tile and click on it. So this isn't very... this isn't really much news. People have done this before. So he's gonna go ahead and beat... He's gonna go ahead and win, right? Let's take a look. Yeah, so he collects all the coins, he wins. And then when he goes back to the map, he goes back as Luigi. Right? And that's like sort of the glitch, I guess. So yeah, there's no way to replicate this on original hardware. It's not possible. You need to use some kind of cheats and stuff like that. And if we actually go to YouTube, Super Mario Bros. 3, Out of Bounds. Parallel universes from 1 year ago, 100th coin, which is amazing at everything he does. Oh, apparently we have to watch an ad. Everything you need to- Vertical Out of Bounds, let's see what he does here. Yeah, let's take a look. Okay, this is a very, very in-depth. Let's do... actually, let's take a look at this.
Undocumented discovery in Super Mario Bros. 3. If you put in a code to move anywhere in the map, you can go into the upper left-hand corner in single player to activate a Mario Bros. Stage. Funny enough, if you win as Mario, then you can take control of Luigi with player 2.
Okay. Let's see if there's any... In two-player game, you can enter the same stage as your partner to enter this minigame to collect coins. I don't remember if this is true or not, but I believe regardless of whether you win or lose, if the other player's turn once the minigame is over, that is not true. If you win, it is your turn. So that was... I don't know if you guys ever remember when you were little, but, you know, you play against your brother or sister. If you keep... Every time they cross your path, that was, like, the scary part, right? Having to cross the previously beaten stage that, like, your brother or friend did. Brother, sister, friend, whatever. And they're mashing the button to try and pull you in to beat you so that they get another turn. That's what all that minigame's about. So... So this again, you know, 2017, look, out of bounds, somebody's already using a glitch to go out of bounds. So, I don't know. It's weird that it's getting all this traction when it's just, look at this garbled mess. Like, look, somebody's in, that is something we've seen before. you go to the warp zone and you can like go out of bounds. So I mean, Mario 3 isn't even really getting much news at this point, but it is, you know, interesting to see that people are messing around, I guess. I mean, what is this? Let's go ahead and take another look over at Twitch. We have a couple people speedrunning in Mario 3. Let's take a look at, we know Louis. What is it? Louis_88 or something? What the hell's his name? There it is. No, it's just Louis underscore. I knew it. It's Teeks88 that I'm looking for. So Louis is also a Mario 3 speedrunner lately who has just been grinding Mario 3. Where's his videos? Right here. Click his videos. So let's see, he goes for 100%. He's going for the 100% world record right now, and he's trying to beat, I think he's just trying to get a sub 110.03 right here at the bottom. He's just trying to get sub 110.03. And as you can see, he grinds for quite a while, and he does get traffic. This was 10 days ago. It looks like he's taken a little bit of a break. We got 10 days ago was the one I clicked on. It's a good chunk of viewers. And honestly, he is definitely somebody who can beat the record. And that will definitely shed some light on Mario 3. I mean, if he beats that run, he will definitely, you know, like I said, bring some life back to Mario 3. We also have another runner, Teeks88, right here. He is also back into Super Mario Bros. 3. He left for a while. He went on a break. When he went on break, and after I went on break, and everyone went on break, that was one of the main reasons why I thought Mario 3 was kind of dying down. I still kind of think, you know, in my opinion, I think Mario 3 is actually dying a little bit. It's not staying hugely popular. As you can see, Teeks gets roughly close to the same amount of viewership with his videos as Louis does. So there is still the heart of Mario 3 really trying to watch and enjoy the speedruns. And as you can see, Teeks is a grinder. I mean, he's got almost 7 hours for this grind right here. And he's doing races, he's trying to schedule things. And I mean, a lot of people participate in the points tournament, which is created by me, which hopefully when I bring that back, it's gonna shed some light. If I type in 100th coin, will his YouTube, there it is right here. So we have 100th coin who's constantly messing up shit. We actually just got a brand new task created by him, which it's like I don't even know what it is. It's like 30 frames. He even has a side-by-side compare. Well, no, that, hold on, that's not a side-by-side comparison. I guess that's the RAM watch. Very interesting stuff. So we got a brand new task, very happy about that. It beat the previous task world record. There we go. Cosmic says, there we go. Last one was a little slow. So, I mean, come on, man. You can do better. Let's go. Yeah. So that's really cool. I mean, we got a new task. This is as you can see, 100th coin is a very small YouTuber, but he's very big in Mario 3, but he's getting some views right there, right? He's getting some of the views, which is really nice. And that's kind of what Mario 3 needs, especially for a channel as small as this. Not many people know. But look at this one. He got 16,000 views on this one. I guess it was the end glitch. November 13th. That was my birthday, of course. Record was broken on my birthday. I don't even know if that was a record. I don't think so. Kind of fast. Cosmic, man. He's on top of it. We have a lot of other smaller Mario 3 speedrunners. If we go to speedrun, we go to speedrun.com. Wow, it went right to Mario 3. I wasn't even expecting that. You can see that we have, like, let's say I Love Mario, which is fifth place. I mean, that was 2 years ago. Karua was 6 years ago. Feropen was 1 week ago. Pretty good, man. Pretty good. Feropen is actually a force to be reckoned with. He's a very good Mario 3 speedrunner. But as you can see, the time split between all these categories is just huge, man. Huge. 3 years ago, 3 years ago. I mean, these are the top runners. I mean, Teeks is trying to beat, I don't think actively, I mean, he did 4 months ago, and this is 100%. This is the 100% category. God, look at this, just riddled with ads. Holy jumping. Yeah, we got Yadokami. He's been grinding for quite a while. Not 100% right now. I think he's back to warpless. Stewie has taken a break. Haven't seen Cujo. The Haxor is gone. He used to be very big. the hacks are in Mario 3 speedrunning, but he's just done. He just doesn't, not interested. So he was somebody who helped keep Mario 3 together. Maiba, what I wouldn't say was a leader role in Mario 3. So his actions, it's not as if he made like a massive impact, but he did beat some records. So that did, you know, push Mario 3. See, Zicabi, one of the biggest Mario 3 speedrunners, stopped his 100% runs at the 110.02. Hasn't really grinded much for it, even though he does have some pretty decent time saves, a couple new strats. He does go really hard with the any percent, which, by the way, some new person is right on his tail. It's actually caused C Zicabi to come back and start doing a little bit of any percent runs. I saw him. He's been de-rusting lately. If we go back to Twitch, we type in C Zicabi. Hopefully we got that. C Zicabi has been...
So Kate is helping.
He has been back on the practice. He's been doing a lot of Earthbound, which is like kind of what he is. But as you can see in his thumbnails, he's been doing some Mario 3, trying to get back in. And all of this plays an important role to whether we think Mario 3 is dying. We got news articles that are like kind of shitty. We got one of the biggest Mario 3 speedrunners, which was me, like taking... I want to say I'm retired, but at the same time, if somebody beat my run, I'd probably go back. But, I mean, not being around for 4 or 5 months doing Mario 3 definitely has a big impact on the community. So, Warpless not getting much traffic with any of the top runners. I mean, my 5030 was a couple years ago. C Zicabi a couple years ago. I mean, I know it says 1 year, but it's probably pretty close to saying 2 years. Maiba got his sub 51 4 months ago, so that's kind of new, not really. I mean, he probably was grinding for about 2 months, so I'd say that was a 6 month thing altogether, 2-3 months, 7 months maybe. Karua 4 years ago, still fourth, right? 4 years ago for Open, 5 months ago. Mario 3 years ago. Zone was 7 months ago. I mean, he had to take a break. Teeks over a year ago was his last PB. Hasn't been able to bust it. I know he is grinding Warpless right now. And we have Louis 2 years ago. So, I mean, even the runners that I could think of who are running right now, their PBs are still quite a ways. And I mean, the break between a lot of runners. So I guess to conclude the video, I mean, I think at the heart of Mario 3, it's not dying. I think everyone likes Mario 3. I mean, if I turn on my stream right now and started doing some speedruns, some serious speedruns, it would create a little bit of traction. And I think the same thing happens when runners like Teeks and Louis are grinding for the Warpless record. They're creating the traction. But at the heart of it all, I mean, Mario 3 being one of the most popular speed games there is, and one of the most fan favorite games almost of all time. I mean, everyone knows Mario 3. For it to not have traction the same as, like, let's say Mario 64, Ocarina of Time. I know those are different games, different categories, but Mario 3 was just as popular as those games when it came out. But it's not holding its own very well. Even if we take a look at Discord, which I'm not gonna post the Mario 3 Discord, but there is a lot of traffic going on in the Mario 3 Discord. Unfortunately, all it is the any percent and a couple of those new runners trying to beat that 302 from Zicabi. So, I mean, not many people are overly interested in the any percent. I mean, there's a small group of people who like the any percent category, but at the end of the day, not many people stick around to watch the any percent grinds because it's very reset heavy in World 1. Got to get the right Hammer Brother movements. If not, I mean, you're not beating time. That's all there is to it. So from my personal opinion, which I don't want to say it stretches very far because it's just an opinion, but I think Mario 3 is kind of on a very big downward trend right now in popularity. And I think it would need something big to pull it back. I mean, GDQ is not even having Mario 3 for 2022 for AGDQ. They didn't accept any Mario 3 runs. No randomizers. I know Haxer wanted to do some randomizer stuff. I tried to do some solo runs. I even tried to do a couple ROM hacks. Rift Bros. I think I submitted Orb Bros. I'm not sure. And no. So, to me personally, yeah. I think Mario 3 is kind of slipping a little bit. I want you guys to leave a comment. in the section below. Let me know what you think. Do you think Mario 3 is kind of dying? Do you guys even watch Mario 3 anymore? Should I make Mario 3 videos? But let me know how you feel. I am definitely going to keep making Mario 3 videos. I have another video that I'm in the works with, and it's an in-depth discussion about what a player will need to do to beat my 1041 any percent no wrong warp. It's going to be very interesting. I'm about halfway through. It's going to be a long one. It's going to be like 40, 50 minutes. We really talk about everything. So make sure to check that out when it comes out. And yeah, make sure to share this video so everyone else can see what kind of news is going on. So you guys take it easy, and I hope you enjoy the video, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you. Woo!